Hello, welcome to Mtoto News Insight this week. My name is Eda. Before I start, did you know that sitting down with a teenage son or daughter is to openly discuss different topics works better than shouting? This helps to create a safe space where the child acknowledges the platform to approach with any concern without feeling judged. So just sit back and think about that. On to our first story. The second children journalism training came to an end on Friday, August 16th, after a week of engaging children in theories and practical work around journalism. The program included lessons on camera work, editing, writing, presentation, and interviews, among lots of fun.
Hi, welcome to Mtoto News Second Graduation.
Hi, I'm Chayil.
And I'm Eda.
Hi, everyone.
My name is Ryan Derito.
My name is Vitalis.
Hi, my name is Magdalene.
And my name is Hope.
Hi, my name is Lynn.
And
my name is Marianne, and this is Mtoto News.
Today we are at Mbagathi High School for the Mtoto News program. We learned about media, social media,
and even parts of
it. So in this training, we've learned a lot about communication and media, and how to do interviews, and a lot about filming and editing.
I've learned much more from Tuesday to this day, and today is our graduation, and I've learned about interviews. We have interviewed lots of people and practiced, and we have done presentation. That's what I've learned.
We have learned a lot in trainings, so we are encouraging parents to let their children to come for training in trainings because it's very helpful.
We message to all parents who have children and they have their talent, bring them here to Mtoto News. They learn how to stand for themselves and be sure of what they feel.
Let your children come to Mtoto News because it's so funny and it's good.
Kenya is becoming a soft target for online children traffickers due to high penetration of internet. The Communications Authorities of Kenya says criminals are targeting minors using social media sites like Facebook and Instagram. The authority says it is working with security agents and ICT players to support cyber security in the country. Children of imprisoned mothers have a hard time adjusting to life without a physical present mother and on the International Prisoners Justice Day. Julia marks a new beginning for her children back at home after she was released from Thika Women Prison. Anne Wambui with the story.
August 10th is dedicated to prisoners serving time for different crimes all over the world. This year's event was held at Thika Women Prison, where male and female inmates came together, joined by different private organizations, representatives from the European Union, and government officials from the State Department for Correctional Services. The agenda of the day was driven by the theme, Promoting Access to Justice, Rehabilitation, and Reintegration of Prisoners.
Being in jail is lonely at night. It's waiting for the letters that no one will write.
Two ladies left the closed walls to rejoin an environment they have both been away from for years. Julia and Lydia were all smiles when their now former inmates cheered them on as they moved from one tent to another to signify a transition.
Nasikia raha sana. Sana, sana, sana. Kwa sababu kuingia gerezani na kutoka ni neema ya Mungu. Kwa sababu ni kuzito. Kwa na familia, msichana moja na watoto wawili. Walikuja, walibaki mali nipa nimekomboa. Lakini wakapata na uncle zake, wamekuja kunichukua. Sasa ndio wanaishi nao.
Being behind bars means there is no freedom as one will enjoy not being there. But despite this, the men and women here are acquiring different skills like basic introduction to law, bakery, weaving, and carpentry so that eventually once their time is done, they would be able to fend for themselves, their children, and generally the families left behind. Life does change after leaving prison gates because this is the second chance to live a reformed life, of course, with the right support system.
Sisi kasema niko na hiyo mpango kwa sababu kama saa hii unajua vile umetoka ndio ulivyo. Naona? Kwa hivyo sasa kwa ile mikono nitaanguka kwa hiyo mikono sasa hiyo ndio itafanya hata niweze kujua nitaweza fanya kwa sababu siwezi nikasema nitaenda kufanya hivi sina capital, sina kitu chochote. Kwa hivyo nikianguka pale mikononi mwa wale ndivyo sasa na kukubalika hapo, hapo ndio nitaweza kuendelea safari na mbele.
I am proud that I'm a beneficiary of this new system. As at the time of my arrest, I was a criminal engaging in armed robberies in various parts of our country. But now, I am a shining example of what our prisons can do to those inmates who embrace change.
Together with government, human rights defenders, legal practitioners, we seek to come up with policies or not amendments to the already established law that will see inmates and former inmates treated with dignity they deserve.
It was indeed a beautiful occasion to have Julia and Lydia go back home after serving their time in prison, to be integrated back with their families and to know that this time was an opportunity to correct themselves and be better. From Mtoto News, I am Anne Wambui.
Every child has a right to free, quality, basic education, and it is important for the society to understand the need that comes with the new competency-based curriculum. There is a need to work together to ensure that children's future is safe and protected by giving them a chance to have the best that education can offer. Constance Ndeleko with more.
For the past years, Kenya has been boasting herself to having a very young population with over 50% being below the age of 18. As children recognize government effort to improving education for all. With free basic education, a progressive education law, and just introduced competence-based curriculum. But as children, we are concerned that students may not have enough material at home than in school. You may find that the new CBE process of learning, you may find that there are a lot of resources in school. But when students actually go home, they really suffer from lack of infrastructure, such as homes. They might be really suffering. It may also lead to addiction of students to the internet. Maybe, as you have known, the internet is like a bed bug. When you have it, if you just get one, it will just spread and you'll be addicted. They will be with you everywhere. So, if the internet is opened to the students, it may cause addiction.
So we believe that the new curriculum is good because of the new changes that will help children. For example, it will help children practice their knowledge. For example, in a class we're taught about photosynthesis, so we want to see that leaf growing. So we go outside and plant that tree and see the process of how photosynthesis occurs. Number two, it's flexible. It's flexible for all. For the people here in Nairobi and the people in Turkana and Wajir. Number three, children can showcase and develop talent. There are some people who are not talented in academics, but are talented in either music and sports. So they can showcase their talent, and that will be better for them. Number four, it is determined by the child's pace. What we had said that if someone is a slow learner, by the time they go to the next class, they have been able to understand everything that they were taught in the last class. Number five, it is learner-centered. The learners are given an opportunity to participate in class and there are no favoritism in class, and everyone is expected to learn and participate in class.
We request the government to do the following: to build classrooms, libraries, laboratories and workshops, to provide finance for all schools from nursery school. As you can see, the government, these finances, for example, the scholarship, the government provides scholarship to secondary schools and primary, but they leave the pre-primary schools, that's the nursery school.
In my opinion, there are a lot of children who are left behind, so that education should be free to all, those with disabilities, those refugees, and those who are unable, those slow learners.
CBC is not for the rich. That's why technology is provided, is going to be provided in schools for every child to get.
And finally, in sports, the Kenyan secondary teams was flagged off for the Eastern African Games, which is scheduled to take place from 17th to 26th August in Tanzania. Dennis Njoroge with the report.
Over 50 teams featuring about 500 students as well as coaches and officials will set off for Arusha for the annual East Africa Games 2019. The 18th edition of the annual games gets underway next week with schools from 6 countries including Kenya, Burundi, Uganda, Tanzania, Zanzibar and Rwanda set to compete for titles in volleyball, handball, football, basketball, rugby, swimming, hockey, athletics, netball and racket games. The teams have been camping at Olekajuado and Moi Isinya Secondary School in Kajiado County, where they have been fine-tuning their skills since Sunday. The squad was officially flagged off on Wednesday at Olekajuado Secondary School by the County Commissioner Joshua Nkatha and the County Education Director Luca Kibet. Kenya is the overall defending champions after claiming 28 medals from a compilation of 10 gold, 8 silver and 10 bronze during last year's showpiece. Uganda came second after bagging a total of 25 medals, while the host collected 16 medals, with 4 of them being gold, 5 silver and 7 bronze. From Mtoto News, I'm Dennis Njoroge.
And that brief brings us to the end of this week's bulletin. Join us next week for more. Our social media handles are at Mtoto News, and more is available in our website, www.mtotonews.com. I am Ada Asaji.